was about to visit Kano. He gave a date that he's going to visit Kano to meet with his people, to visit his constituency. But instead of him allowed, for him to be allowed and given the necessary security, the police wrote a letter to him advising him not to go. I don't want to go deep into the reason why he was not allowed to go, but Mr. President, as we are sitting here, if somebody, a senator representing his, a particular constituency, will not be allowed to visit his constituency, I think we are not doing good for ourselves. One day, it will become another person. Today is Radio Senator Kwankwaso. And the issue, if you go through the social media yesterday to today, in the presence of State Assembly, in the presence of the state government, in the presence of even part of our people from the National Assembly, if you see the kind of weapon that was that was used, people were parading more in thousands with weapons. And the only route to my constituency is through Kano. And Mr. President, if we don't talk about this issue, this is the beginning, because it took very hard, so many times for this issue of Endeavour in Kano to be calmed. But today we are bringing back the issue of this insecurity in Kano. And we are watching. And Mr. President, I see no reason why a person who wants to travel to his own hometown as a city senator will be prevented just by security. If they are going to prevent him from traveling to his state, then they should give him another date whereby they will give him that security. And we are sure, yes, and we are sure, yes, Mr. President, then the issue of arms, if you look at, I have some pictures. For the first time in the history of this nation, women were giving arms to carry. These are the pictures. Women were giving arms to carry in broad daylight. And in Kano, yesterday, and day before yesterday. And if we don't do anything, these are the pictures, Mr. President, for the first time in the history of our district. And if we don't do anything, and if something starts to happen in Kano, we come here and start making maybe 1 minute prayer for this thing. How can we? Mr. President, this is what happened yesterday and day before yesterday in Kano. How do we give our young people arms to carry? Instead of us to give them work, instead of them to empower them to do the right thing, and think, Mr. President, since the time this issue of crisis only before anything, there has never been a time whereby any prominent person or any person where a politician's son or somebody that is doing well falls victim of this. It is always the innocent people, it is always the politician. They will give drugs to people, they will give them arms. I think, Mr. President, we need to investigate what is happening.
So, Senator Issa, what is the prayer? Your mic, yeah?
The prayer first is to condemn what happened in Kano. Then secondly is to investigate what happened so that at least issues of this kind of issues that in Taraba, Benue, and other things will not start in Kano. If we don't do that, if we allow people to be given arms openly to the youth instead of giving them job.
My internal party squabble in Kano. What we did yesterday and the day before yesterday was to go out for campaign in respect of our local government election. And he's stating facts that he doesn't know about. He's given false story to the Senate. In our own kind of politics, we have segments. We have women segment, we have our traditional hunters, and they are very good component of our political structure. Whenever we're having campaign, they do come. He knows that himself, but he's not being used by some other people to blackmail us. It's blackmail, Mr. President, by stating what is not true, giving facts, giving story that is not true to this August Senate, Mr. President. We never fought anybody. Nobody fought. Nobody killed anyone. There was no quarrel yesterday. Yet, he's bringing stories that undermine our own political structure in Kano. This is not fair. When you come to the floor of the Senate to undermine the structure the political structure, the political organization of a fellow senator, I think is unfair. You need to call Isahama to order. This is not fair. And when you do this, tomorrow I'm going to bring a motion in respect to what is happening in your states. I will do that, Mr. President.
All right. Thank you. All right. Thank you, Senator. Senator, do sit down. All right. Senator Rabiu Kwankoso, I have noticed you are not contributing to this discussion. Do you have anything to contribute?